What's up? Welcome back to the channel, baby! We are back at it again!
I don't like how there's a car seat in the back. People are gonna think I have a kid.
Bridget's a nanny, folks.
She yeah, I don't have a kid.
She's a nanny, so that's why there's a car seat in the back. Pick me up some Dunkin', thank you.
It's approximately 6 days from opening day here in Pennsylvania, and we're getting a pretty late start to setting up some stands.
Yeah, we are.
But yeah, me and Grant have permission to hunt this one property.
And Fred.
So yeah, and my dad. That's kind of where we got the permission from.
That's kind of how we got permission.
Yeah, that's how we got permission. But we are on our way there this morning to go set up a stand. We got the dog. We got the boyfriend. Coffee. We're running late, like always.
Like usual, Fred's gonna be mad.
Like usual, yeah, Fred's gonna be mad.
That's okay.
But we're excited. Should be a good day. It's gonna be pretty hot, so trying to get in and out as soon as we can.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
All right, folks. Hope you guys enjoy. What do you think, Carson?
He's ready.
Everybody, meet Dad, Fred.
Hey, how you doing? So we're gonna check these two other tree stands back here along the edge of the creeks. Come on, buddy. Damage from the last storm.
Yeah.
We'll have to start making a new route to get back.
Oh yeah, look at that.
See, they've been starting to use this trail a little bit.
Is there a stand pretty close up here?
Yeah. We have this tall weeds. I don't really know exactly what type it is, but it's been like a really great bedding area for them over the years.
Yeah.
Which is, allows them a lot of cover, and they can sneak in and sneak out in different areas. They kind of come down across the creek and then into it. And then in the evening, they've been getting up and then traveling out of it and then going up the ridge and onto the next field up in the hill.
Yeah, I can see on my map there's fields up there.
Yeah.
So are those crops this year?
We'll have to go around and look when we're done.
Yeah.
And see exactly what's going on.
Nice.
Okay.
Yeah, this looks good, though.
Ridge, and they'll actually come back down around,
yeah,
and then back into here. So they're not, you know, too disturbed.
Yeah, you can kind of get away with it
exactly.
A little more here
you
than
can
other places.
Yeah.
That's really nice.
Yeah, they kind of have a really cool routine in here, and their patterns really don't ever change that much.
That's
you know, a lot of times you come in, you know, early fall. And then you come in during the rut and the pattern's completely changed. And a lot of times this pattern stays the same here. I don't know why, but it doesn't.
That's interesting.
Yeah, because usually patterns, and once you get into that first week of the rut, forget it.
Forget about it, yeah.
All the patterns completely changed.
Yeah. Yeah, we're going in that stuff.
We're going in there.
Yep.
See the bottom of the ladder sticking? That's the first stand, right where the
What's funny too is like 10 seconds before we saw them, you were like, "I'm surprised we haven't bumped any yet." And then 5 seconds later, there they were.
Yeah, they're here.
That's cool.
They're heavily here.
Look, I can see that trail that goes right under the stand.
Very pronounced.
That's like very defined.
Yeah. When we get heavy rains, this will get flooded out.
Yeah.
And it pushes them out for 3 or 4 days, but then they're right back in here.
Yeah.
Right back down in here. So that's the first tree
place is pretty cool. Well, this isn't the first time you're seeing it. She's used to it. This is the first time I'm seeing it. Looks really good.
So the only thing this needs is a little netting around the front.
Yeah.
Pick that up later in the week and swing by. Maybe next weekend I'll run up and put that up.
Where's that?
This one is pretty good.
Come here, Cars.
Carson loves this.
Such a good boy.
Yeah. This is what I'm going to stick you in more than likely.
Okay.
Come season.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll go up and I'll take a look.
Coming through here.
Yeah.
Come right through here. Yeah.
Are you a good dog?
He's
so happy.
I wonder if Marley would be relaxed if he brought it out here.
I think he'll relax his head.
I don't have my phone with me.
Who gave you those ratchet straps?
Do you have the picture?
I have the picture.
Where'd you get them?
Walmart.
Oh, yeah?
Your neighborhood Walmart.
More like me, Amazon.
Mm-hmm. That's funny. Hey, he's going in your truck when you go home. Not
my truck. Carson, sit. Carson, lay down.
Let's go. Go on, buddy.
So then there's one other stand already up too.
Yeah, we're going to go to that one next. So that's the actual area over here where that scrape was. Last year, that big, I call them bathtub scrapes, multiple use scrapes.
Yep.
So, I was thinking about maybe this tree doesn't have a lot of cover on it though. We could actually do that one and cover this back side over here, face it towards the creek.
Yeah. I mean, that looks like
a
decent tree.
Yeah, I'm a left-hand shooter.
Okay.
So, actually, that would cover some of this spot for me.
Yeah.
You know, I often thought about that in there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, in that tree.
That tree, it's got a lot of cover all the way around.
Yeah.
You'd have to trim some stuff out, but that would cover this whole thing and some of that.
Yeah.
It is a little close to that stand, but
yeah.
You know the way deer can be. You know, 1 minute they're, you know, it could be 20, 35, 45 yards away and you really can't get a shot.
Yeah.
If we stuck somebody in that tree,
somebody would get them.
Yeah, somebody might have a better opportunity. Last year, this is where this 190 class walked right through.
Really?
And he just strolled through like he owned the neighborhood. And he more than likely did.
Yeah.
So.
Wow.
Yeah, maybe we should do that.
Yeah.
Do that tree.
Yeah.
Get a lot more cover.
Is that the trail that big deer was on?
Yeah.
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 When he came from over here.
So he came from back here. I'm thinking, you know, it was the second week of November, you know, in that peak part of the rut.
Yeah.
That he was actually working that big scrape that I sent you that picture of. So
yeah.
I'm show everybody show, on show film, you know, yeah. what that deer was actually
huge,
working.
Huge scrape.
Yeah, he's a big boy.
Yeah.
Made me a little nervous.
Yeah.
That's the next tree stand.
Nice.
So he was working that trail. I had him 20 yards right here. Had him broadside 20 yards. The problem was I was watching a 10 pointer back in the woods, you know, and then all of a sudden the 10 pointer looked like, you know, hey, what the heck's going on here?
Yeah.
So he kind of turned and went the other way, and I knew I wasn't winded. Looked over to my right, and he was standing, that 190 was standing right here.
So yeah. He came in silent.
Yeah. Very silent. He walked over to that ridge over there. See how that kind of really skirts
up. That's
pretty
steep.
Yeah, and a lot of does lay up on that hill in the wintertime or the late, late fall. Because it gets a sun and all in the afternoon. Yeah. And they just lay up there and sun themselves.
Yep.
So he actually went up to the ridge, and instead of going up the hill, which I thought he was going to do, he actually went to the left 30 yards and then walked back literally to me.
Wow.
Yeah. But 40 yards out, I thought he was 40, but he was 47.
Yeah.
So, and I shot underneath of him.
Yeah.
It happens,
yeah.
Happens a lot, and if anybody says it doesn't, they're telling you a story.
Yeah, exactly.
So this one over here, it looks like it got a lot of debris in front of it from the last storm, from the hurricane that we just recently had come up.
Yeah.
Ida.
That.
Tracks in the mud.
Tracks where they're coming through.
Yeah. So pretty much all season can be good in here, but like your favorite would be like second weekend of
my favorite is the first and second week with that peak of that rut.
Yeah.
But
that 190 went, was that first week in November? Somewhere in there.
Yeah, somewhere in the first week in November. Yeah. Which I plan, I'm taking the whole week off that week.
The first week in November. Okay. Nice.
Yeah, get that rut in.
Yeah. Consistency is nice for
it's
us.
It's a beautiful thing.
Like, if you don't have to be coming in here scouting all the time to try to figure it out, you can stay out because you know what they're going to do.
Exactly.
You only have to come in when you got to do stand work like this.
This is nice because it's, there's a lot of good hardwood in here. There's hickories in here. There's acorns in here. And they really, really kind of, clean this area up real good.
And just like what I love, when like I just like look at this like from a general sense, like I mean it's so clear to see the deer have everything they need, like in such a small area.
Absolutely.
Water, cover, food, like that's the three things they need, and it's all here.
And they don't have to go far.
They don't have to go far, yeah.
And the pressure. So this area, the property owners have deemed this archery only.
Okay.
They don't want anyone coming in here and gunning.
Yeah.
And that makes it even better because the pressure isn't on. There's not a lot of, a lot of heavy pressure during, actual gun season.
Yep.
And I found out though, in the surrounding areas here where the pressure is real heavy, it literally pushes them down in here. And we've archery hunted in right through gun season through here. I'd rather archery hunt than gun hunt. It's a little more up in personal.
Yeah. That's always the beautiful thing about a place that isn't gun hunted is like if everyone else is gun hunting around here,
they're just driving them down where they know they feel a little more secure.
Yeah.
I haven't picked up a gun in 35 years.
Yeah.
I've killed every deer with a bow.
Archery only.
That's I wouldn't have cool. it any other way.
That's pretty cool though.
It's really, really. And if you don't do it, do it.
Yeah. No, there's
try it.
There's definitely some people watching that will appreciate that. I know.
I used to shoot only Bear and Jennings bows and then I was never a crossbow guy. And then I started having serious shoulder problems and I went to a crossbow and it's just as much fun. It really, really is. Don't let anybody tell you that it isn't.
I
give you that.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people, you're using a crossbow. And it's like,
they think it's cheating.
Look, get in the woods and hunt because it's a dying art and it's a dying sport. Even though you see more and more stuff, it's really, really, there's more. It seems like there's becoming more anti-hunter. And
I love that they made those legal because, just like you said, I mean, it just is, it's going to allow more hunters to get out. Like you said, it's a dying, hunting numbers are going down.
Going down. License sales are going down.
And that's going to get more kids out.
And that's my biggest thing. My biggest thing has always been kids. My kids grew up in the woods.
Yep.
they were always in the woods. They were always out scouting with me. Even when they were little, they would sit in trees. You know, I would buy two-man stands and bring them out.
Yeah.
You know, just to get them acclimated into it. Mm-hmm. You know.
Yep.
And they were all grown up on deer meat. This one over here, she can't even really stomach beef
she
too much.
She yet. Doesn't eat anything.
She's literally a little too rich
yeah.
for them, you know?
Yeah. No, I mean, that's...
My son, he's out in Montana, and he was already out scouting.
Yep.
Lucky him.
Yeah.
Wish we could all get out there, but someday yeah. we will.
He's loving life out there, it sounds yeah. like.
But Pennsylvania right now is becoming the place to be.
Yeah, Pennsylvania's starting to grow some big deer here.
Very big deer.
It's getting... It's probably...
It's amazing the difference in the last...
He just gnawed that whole branch.
He's helping clean up.
Good boy.
Good job, buddy. You know, the whole three, you know, 3 point on one side was a great decision, in my opinion, from the...
Oh, yeah.
From the game commission.
Yeah.
And...
I agree.
You know... My whole philosophy's always been, that's good for the deer. We're getting bigger deer. Eventually, we're going to hopefully catch up to like these places like Pike County, Illinois,
yeah.
and all.
Yeah.
And
I think
and get the bigger size yeah. deer in here. Yeah, and we're doing it.
Yeah.
We're doing it now.
We're definitely getting a lot closer than we were.
There's a guy who I use, and I'm going to plug him. His name is Mike Zander Taxidermy. You can look him up online. One of the best taxidermies in the area. And if you go over to his place and you look at some of the class deer that are just coming from Pennsylvania, it's yep. unbelievable.
Yep. No, I totally agree. I think it's as good as it's right now is as good as it's ever been.
It's going to get better.
And it's going to keep getting better. Yeah.
You know, and then for the people who keep saying, oh, well, it's a spike and it's going to be a spike, or if it's an older deer and it's just got big wide horns, but it doesn't have... Bring a kid. Get yeah. a kid. Yeah. Get a kid into hunting. Get him a exactly. mentor license, because a mentor can shoot a deer like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know? Yeah. And then that way, if you want to eliminate that type of deer, you know, there you go.
Perfect opportunity yeah. for somebody.
Absolutely, and a perfect opportunity for a young, you know, girl or boy to get a wonderful deer, you know? A deer that some people never get in a lifetime.
Right.
Or never even right. see in a lifetime. Yeah. This stand is not for the faint of heart.
Yeah.
Again, I'd like to move some of that stuff, but it seems like it's an awful lot. Maybe we can move a couple of them branches and just get this trail kind of reestablished.
Yeah.
You know, do you want to come up and take a look?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll come up.
Hey, you see that tree there?
Yeah.
I'm going to actually fold that over.
Oh, yeah.
I don't like to cut trees. I try not to. I try to either fold them back or just not yep. break them, but just kind of manipulate them back into a different area.
Just enough to get
it. Just enough lane. To give you a yeah. shot. So... I had him right there 20 yards.
Yep.
When I first, but if you look back out this way, now November, all the cover's down. So I had a 10 pointer over there.
How big was that one?
He was probably maybe 125 class,
yeah.
115, 125. He was a nice deer.
Nice
you know?
Deer, but nothing like that one.
Nothing like that one.
Yeah.
And the little, I call him a little 10, but he wasn't that. In some people's eyes, he wasn't that little.
Yeah.
But I had him, I was pretty much focused on him, and the other one came right through here.
Yeah.
Right along the grass line.
Just
and
silent.
And he was standing there, and I was watching the 10, and he turned around, and he just, like, got nervous and took off.
Yep.
And I said, what the heck is he? Because the wind was in my face, and I looked yeah. over, and there he was. Well, he got out over here about 30 yards, I believe it is, that next one tree out there in the center. I have it pinned at 30 yards. He got out there, my scope was fogged, so I couldn't get a shot of him on. It was like one of them things where it was, everything that went wrong could have went wrong.
Yeah, right.
And then I had him out there at 40 yards.
Yep.
But, you know, one of them things. There's always next year.
Yeah, not much you can do.
No, you just got to get back out. Yep. Keep at it, you know. A buddy of mine who does come down here and hunt from time to time, and he said that he had saw another one that was not as big, but darn close to it in size. So, so there's a couple nice bruisers.
Yeah, and even that this 10 you had seen over here,
could be a nice year. Yeah, it probably might have been in the same gene pool. We don't know. We'll find out. It's a nice spot.
Yeah, it is.
And we're very blessed to have homeowners that are willing to let us hunt here.
Yeah.
You can't stress enough to homeowners that are giving you permission, be polite, hook them up, give them a gift card, bring them some of the meat, do something to make it, worth their while time, and their time.
Well, yeah.
Them being nice and it's.
Yeah, because everybody's into this liability thing today and, they don't want to give us, a lot of us, permission to hunt, Done, but you're all wet and you're going to get in my truck and muddy. Do you think it's funny? And my seats
good
are going to be.
Boy! Good boy! Good boy!
I don't have anything to put down.
What's
I'll have to find something to lay down on the seats.
Why don't we just.
In my truck like that.
He's so muddy.
I'll fold up the seat and you can.
Look at him, he's so happy.
I'm going to fold up the seat and
look at how happy he is.
I'm gonna fold up the seat and you can sit on the floor with him.
Look at how happy he looks.
Mm-hmm. He is happy.
He's just a baby.
All right, good. And we picked out a nice spot for another sandwich, which we will put up next week.
And we got a muddy dog.
Yeah, we do.
All right.
Well, I don't really know what to say.
Final thoughts, Fred?
Yeah, get out, shoot straight. Get your kids involved.
Yep.
Want to see the young people come in and get involved in this sport and keep it going. Got to keep it alive.
Thanks for coming to our video. Next week, hopefully we'll be shooting something. Bye, guys.